सर वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग सर
गुड मॉर्निंग सर
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग सर सर
गुड मॉर्निंग सर
यस सर यस सर सर मैडम इज देयर डॉक्टर बालकोटेश्वरी मैडम डीन एंड एकेडमिक्स
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग सर वेलकम टू यू
थैंक यू
फ्रॉम संस्कृति ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस यस
थैंक यू
वेंकटेशन सर कैन वी कंटिन्यू
या वी कैन कंटिन्यू मैम कैन आई स्टार्ट इट
Yes.
Yeah, I will introduce sir Venkat sir, and then I will ask you to take over. Then you can start, sir.
Sure.
Yeah. A very good morning to all. With immense pleasure, I would like to introduce Venkat sir to you, all of you today. Mr. Venkat is a personality development trainer and a motivational speaker. Venkat sir believes that the present may be filled with limitations, but actual potential is limitless. By harvesting inert energy, one can become catalyst to their own success. He believes training is transformation. Venkat sir is widely experienced and a multifaceted personality. He has undergone a 4-month rigorous training in Indian Academy of Training and Development, a renowned training academy headed by Dr. Rajan, who himself is a trainer from the last 25 years and produced so many trainers in the field of public speaking and professional skills. His persuasive nature inspires and encourages people to realize their inner potential and ensures positive transformation in them. Sir is a virtuous believer and an optimistic trainer. This quality of him ensures all his training sessions are dynamic, energetic, result-oriented, and value-oriented. Venkat sir is postgraduate in management studies with 10 years of valuable experience in sales and marketing domains. He holds an award as best district officer in 2015 in the field of marketing. Sir has designed very high standards training programs as well. His niche areas of training are effective communication, public speaking, relationship, time management, team building, creativity, and storytelling. As a part of training, sir mingled with different executives from diverse fields such as CGI Matrix, Aurobindo Pharma, Air Force, wellness coach and psychologist, chartered accountant and software professionals, sales professionals and professors, etc. His optimism and never say die an attitude is very infectious and makes his training programs uplifting, inspiring, and motivational. Sir has delivered a lot of lectures which are thought-provoking and deep, and his activities always creates fun in the audience. His sessions will leave you with full of energy and motivation. Sir, I welcome you to deliver a talk to our students, MBA students from first year and second year, and they are waiting to listen to you about time management.
Thank you, ma'am.
Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, madam, for your kind introduction about me. Thank you very much. And good morning, student.
Yeah.
Are you able to hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah, good morning, student. I welcome you all for this webinar on time management. I think you got a brief about me, what I am and how I became a trainer and what the kind of experience what I have. So let's not go into all these things and we'll just directly start into the session. It's all about, clearly you are all informed that it's all about time management. Time is very much important in everyone's life and time is very precious in everyone's life. And we are all born with unique characteristics. We have different parameters to differentiate others from each and everyone. But there are certain things which we have very common in nature. There are certain things which we have very common because there are certain things which we need to be shared with everyone. And in that parameter, this number is very common for everyone. Can you know what exactly this number? Can anybody know this number? 86,400 seconds we have in each day. This number is common for everyone, whether you are a student, whether you are an employee, whoever may be. This 86,400 seconds is common for everyone. In the same way, 1440 minutes are common for everyone. In the same way, 24 hours is common for everywhere, whether he is an achiever, is a non-achiever, or whether he's a student or an employee, whoever it may be, this time is very common and we call it as a time. And you are all seeing this picture. This is a small kid who is going to school in Hyderabad. This picture has been taken in the last year, and this picture has grabbed the attention of National Minister of HRD, and they informed all the schools in Hyderabad that no school should be start before 9 o'clock. See the picture, the small baby is taking her breakfast in her pocket. See, the people are feeling that they don't have time. They are feeling that there is a lack for time. So this is a kind of situation where we are living. Even small children don't have time to eat properly. This is the fast running race we are leading right now. So please don't get into the trap of running race of killing time. So she is simply saying that I don't have time. Is this correct? No, this is not correct actually, because being a small kid, the kid should have proper and ample time for food to eat and proper time to sleep. So please don't make the small kids to get into the race of running out of time. For this, we need to all have proper time management. What exactly the time management is? Time management is nothing but it's coming to a definition. Time management is the process of organizing and planning how to divide your time between specific activities. In 24 hours of day, you need to have different tasks to perform. Morning, you should have some tasks. Evening, you should have some tasks. Afternoon, you have some tasks to perform. So in order to complete all these tasks, you need to have proper planning. And after planning, you need to organize at what time you are going to perform which activity. That planning, that organizing, that scheduling of all these activities should be done in a proper way. That itself is called as time management. The next thing is, being busy is not same as being effective. Most of the people think that if you are busy in doing work, they are doing correct things and they are doing the things effectively. That's not correct actually. You should not be always in a hurry mood to complete the work. Don't be in the state of being busy every time. Have ample time to complete your work, have ample time to study, have ample time to play, have ample time to socialize with people. Everything you need to have done in a proper way in a particular time. So don't be in a hurry. In this, I just want to quote a small example about Mr. Narayana Murthy, the founder chairman of Infosys. He used to tell their employees in Infosys, don't be late in the office. Come office on time, leave office on time, and you have your own work. Learn some good habits, learn some different hobbies, and do all these things. Learn some new languages, learn some music. He used to tell like that. If any worker is using his late hours after 5 o'clock, then that employee is considered as a non-effective employee. So the time frame which they'll give to the office is, because earlier it was only the 9 to 5 time, but it's 24/7 now. Based on their time, whatever the time slot given to the employee, in that time slot only, the employee should complete his or her task. So don't be in the state of being busy every time 24/7. And time management is nothing but managing yourself. If you manage yourself properly in a day, then it completely comes under time management. Time is nothing but yourself. You yourself managing your things is nothing but time management. So managing yourself is comes under time management. This is particularly for the students actually. Most of the students have seen in colleges and schools, they'll come late for the school or college, whatever may be the time. If it is 8 o'clock, they'll come by 8:10. If it is 9, they'll come by 9:10, 9:15, like that. So most of the students have seen that 20 to 25% of the students will come late for schools and colleges. So this kind of activity should not be encouraged by the students. What they'll think on the day, if they are coming late on the day, they'll think that they should not come late by next day. They'll feel the same thing on the same day, that they never be late again. They'll think on that day and they leave by evening, and again the next day the same thing repeats, that comes under you are late again. So I have seen a lot of people, a lot of students, when I attended seminars and attended anything, that even when I attended my sales meetings also, some of the colleagues will come late by the meeting. If it is 9, they'll come by 9:10. So if it is 9:30, they'll come by 9:45. So if you are not coming to the class, or if you are not coming to any seminar, if you are not coming to any meeting on time, that is you are not managing your time properly. It's just because of poor time management. If you have poor time management, you will not do your work properly. So you need to have proper time management techniques to use your time properly and to attend your class, your college, and your meeting and your seminar on time. So don't be late, my dear students. Be on time to the class. And everyone is in hurry, but only someone reaches their place on time. This is very common in India. When I used to work in metro cities, I used to see people have their breakfast in metros, in buses, and in autos. So the thing is, people don't have time to even don't have time to eat food properly, because they don't have correct proper time management techniques in their life. They'll waste their time in such a way that they'll always hurry, in such a way that they do the things in different way. And they'll go to office, they'll not on proper time. If they go to cinema, they'll not proper on time. If you go to any meeting, they'll not on proper time. If they go to any function, they'll not proper on time. So everyone is in a mood of hurry. I'm hurry. But they are not reaching their destination on time. So don't please be in a hurry to reach your destination. Be very fast, and be very planned in a situation that you reach your destination on time. Whatever it may be, it's a class, it's a meeting, it's an exam, it's a function, it's a cinema, anything. Please be reach on time. Don't be in a hurry. For this, you need to have proper effective time management. If you have effective time management in your life, then you'll always attend all the things on time. These are the top 5 management skills one should have to use their 24/7 completely without any disturbances. First thing is prioritizing. This prioritizing is nothing but, if you have 100 tasks to perform in a day, you need to have prioritized which tasks you are going to perform in the first place, and which tasks you are going to complete in the second phase, which tasks you are going to complete in the third phase. That is prioritizing. You have to numbering all the tasks, which one should be in the number 1, which one should be in the number 2, and which one should be in the number 3. After the prioritizing all your 100 tasks by basic on numeric things, and then you need to have proper scheduling of doing things in proper way. If you have took the number 1 task, when you are going to complete, whether you are going to complete today, or whether you are going to complete by today evening, or whether you are going to complete by tomorrow morning. That is the scheduling of proper things and tasks. In this scheduling, you need to have daily schedule and weekly schedule. In this day, what you are going to do. Next day, what you are going to do. In the next week, what you are going to do. In the same manner, you need to schedule all your tasks in a proper manner. You need to prepare a certain calendar, and you need to follow strictly the calendar so that you can achieve your task, and you can complete your task, and you can achieve your goals also. And the third thing is, keep a to-do list. After completion of work, you need to write which work you have completed. You have to checkmark the box, and you have to say that you have completed your task, so that you don't need to worry whether the task is going to complete or not. After completion of work, you need to have proper checkup whether you have completed it or not. And the fourth thing is delegation. Delegation of work to others. If it comes to the student, if any project has been given by any professor to the student, if the team members contains of 5 to 8 members, only 2 to 3 members of the team will do the work, and remaining will get the opportunity of completion of the work. But that should not be done, because if you do others' work, it will kill your own time. If you are killing your own time, then it comes under killing yourself. So don't do others' work. Do your own work and delegate your work to the others. In this delegation, you need to get that you have a proper confidence on others also. If you don't delegate work to the others, you'll feel that you don't have confidence on others. So if you delegate the work to others and build confidence on them and try to build confidence for them also, so that we are also going to complete the work in a proper way, that in a proper time given by the professor. So delegate your work and plan your time accordingly. And next, the fifth and the most important thing is resting. One should have proper rest in their life. They should have proper sleep for the 6 to 8 hours per day, because if you are not going to take rest after completion of all these works, your next day is going to be very hectic, because you will be in a certain mood that your energy levels will be very down, and you don't have proper proper sleep also, you don't have energy. So you need to have proper sleep, and so that your energy levels will be boosted up for the next day, so that you will complete your task but according to the schedule. So please remember these 5 tasks, students. The first thing is prioritizing, scheduling, keeping to-do list, and delegation and resting. And next, coming to time matrix. This is a time management matrix. Here, I just want to quote an example of a former U.S. president, Mr. Benjamin Franklin. He is an U.S. president where he used to do all the things for the public. But the public and the governors and the senators always used to complain that this work has not been completed, this work is impending, this work is not done properly. So all these complaints he gets. Whenever he go to office, he'll always get into the complaint. So he decided what is going to be done for the next day. And he invited one consultant, Mr. Stephen Covey, and he said that this is the kind of situation. I'm doing all the things, but the people are not happy with my work, and the senators and the governors are not happy with my work. What I want to do? So the Stephen Covey has been examined all the things what he has done, and he has given this 4 quadrant. The president work has been divided into 4 categories. The first category is urgent and this is important. The second category is not urgent but it is important. The third category is not important but it's urgent. The fourth category is not important and not urgent. Based on these things, the US president thing has been demarcified, and then the task has been completed based on this priority list. So after the completion of the next year, people and the governors are happy that whatever the important and urgent works are going to done, they're all completed, and the remaining works are completed by the next schedule. This is the kind of thing. Based on that only, Mr. Stephen Covey has been designed this time matrix. For the students also, it's very important. If it is homework which is given today, it is urgent and it is very important to complete by tomorrow. So they have to do it, do now. If you are leading any meeting club, you have to do it now. Any shift that is by evening, you have to do it now. It is because it is urgent and it is important to you. And the second quadrant, this is not urgent but important. If you have any project to complete by the end of this week, so it is not urgent, but it is very important to complete by the end of the week. So you need to have proper schedule, proper planning to complete the work. So you need to plan for that work, your exercise, your wellness, your career development, your resume preparing also. For the second year students, if you have a placement in the month of March, if you have a plan of preparing resume by this end of December, so you need to have proper planning. Preparation of resume is not urgent, but is important. So plan your time accordingly, how much time you are going to spend on resume preparation. So this second category is not urgent, but important. Coming to the not important and urgent, if you are living in any hostel or campus, then if your friend is calling for a dinner, it's not an urgent. If you don't have to take the dinner, there's nothing wrong in that. But it's not an important thing. So you can decide whether to go for the dinner or not. If you are attending any club meetings, you have to decide whether you have to attend or not. If you can delegate any work to others also, that work you can delegate. That's considered not important and it's an urgent work. When it comes to fourth quadrant, it's not urgent and not important. That comes, you can completely reduce and you can completely eliminate all things. These are things like wasting time by seeing TV, social media, any distraction, time wasters, time killers, chit chatting. All these comes under not important and not urgent. So, my dear students, please demarcate your all tasks of completion of your task into four different things. These four quadrants will can be useful for you to complete your task accordingly the priority list. This is a self-assessment paper. You can take it from your professor so that you can take any printout and you can use the self-assessment thing. You learn all, you take all these 10 questions. You just say yes or no for all these questions. And in the next slide, I'm going to give the marking of all these things. If you have yes, you have to give 1 mark for the sum question. And if you have no for the answer, you have to give 1 mark for the question. The question. So that if you have high score, then you have proper, you are managing your proper correctly. But if you have, if you get any less score, that should be very, you are not managing your proper time. The first question is, have you estimated how many hours you need to study this semester? See, if you have this semester, how have you estimated? See, in which subject I am going to spend my number of hours, in which subject I am strong and in which subject I am weak. So that based on that, you need to allocate time for the weaker subject rather than the stronger subject. You tend to complete your assignment. Most of the people rush in the end of the day to complete their assignment. So don't be in a hurry to complete your assignment. Complete your assignments on time. Have you estimated how long it takes to read one chapter in each of it? There are certain chapters which will be very tough. So you need to estimate proper time for the tough subject and you need to delegate less time to the chapters which are very easy for you to understand. The fourth one is, do you begin working on long-term assignments on beginning of the semester? If the assignment is a long-term one, which you are going to submit at the end of the semester, then there is no need to hurry to start the work immediately and you spend a lot of time on that. So if the semester, if you are going to submit the project at the end of the semester, have ample time to complete in a proper way. So don't be in a hurry. Do you make list of things to do in your head rather than on paper? Most of the people that think that in the head, in the mind, they'll think that this thing I'm going to do, this thing I'm going to do in that time. But that should not work out. Please write it on paper when you are going to do what. Thus, it is very important for the student to plan properly to prepare for exams or to complete assignments or to complete any project or to complete for any interview also. Please write your plan on paper. And do you participate in social activities even when you know you should be studying? Social activities nowadays have become very, very important. So please be participative in social activities where you can build your confidence levels, where you can build your talking abilities, where you can get information, get knowledge from others. So please plan your social activities also according to your study schedule. Do you schedule time to study for exams? Most of the people think that if there is an exam tomorrow morning, they'll prepare in the night. So that should not be correct because always you need to have proper time schedule to prepare for exam. Don't be in a hurry to prepare for exam. Do you have a job that requires more than 20 hours a week? There are certain people which have their proper financial positions and all those things. They'll have certain part-time jobs. So they should have some proper calculation of how much time you are going to spend on work and how much time you are going to spend on studies. The same way, do you exactly what tasks are going to do when you sit down to study? When you are sitting for study, don't distract you yourself from the other things. Because if you distract from other things, you will be killing your own time. So don't distract when you sit for study. Based on this, if you take printout from your professor and you take this exam, there you yourself for S for 6 and 8 question, except 5th, 6th, 8th, and 10th question. If your answer is S, you 1 point. If no for the remaining questions except 5, 6, 10, then you give 1 mark for the each question and then you add up your score. If your score is very high, then you are using your time properly. If your score is very less, then you are not using any effective time management technique. And how to write your time management schedule? This is a time management schedule which has been divided into four. The first quadrant is master schedule. This master schedule is whenever you, this master schedule has been prepared by you at the starting of your college. When you entered into MBA program, you have to decide at the end of the second year where you are going to stand, whether I'm going to for a job or whether I'm going to start my own startup or whether I'm going to for my dream company or my dream job. This is the master plan, master schedule, where you are, where you want you to see yourself at the end of the second year. And then second term schedule, this can be termed as a semester schedule also. I think most of the exams are being semester wise, first semester, second semester, like that. So for the first semester, you need to have proper schedule. In this semester, what are the subjects? In this semester, what are the projects? And what are the subjects I'm strong and what are the subjects I'm weak? So that I need to allocate my time accordingly to get the weaker subjects into proper way rather than the stronger subjects which I am. So you need to have proper semester schedule, which you need to complete your assignments, which you need to complete your project work according to the end of the semester. And then after writing this semester schedule, you need to have proper week schedule. In this week, do you have any exams? In this week, do you have any projects you are going to complete? In this week, are you going to complete any project? Or in this week, are you going to study any particular subject in which you are weaker? So based on that, you need to have a week schedule. According to that, you need to have proper allocation for your time in order to study properly. And then the daily schedule. If the daily comes under daily routine work, if you are going to submit any assignments today, you are going to submit. You are going to write any exam, appear for any exam. You are going to prepare for the exam in a proper way. So you need to have proper schedule. You need to have a backward calculation. First, you need to prepare your master schedule, where you are going to see at the end of the second year. Based on that, you need to prepare your semester schedule. Based on the semester schedule, you need to have a preparation for week schedule. Based on the week schedule, you need to have proper daily schedule. If all these things you need properly managed, then your time management is at the peak and you will be in a proper way to manage your own time. And by seeing the picture, you come to know that everyone has different tasks to perform, even for the students and even for the employees. Students think that I need to attend the exam and I need to write the exam, I need to complete the assignment, I need to complete the project work, I need to attend some club meetings, I need to write some papers to the paper presentations and all those things. You are in a very confused state that you have a lot of work to do, but you don't have time to do all these things. This is the situation, this is the present generation situation, which you call as, this is a psychological feeling, a feeling of having too much time to do and not enough time to do it. You feel that you have a lot of work to do, but you are feeling that you don't have time to do. This is the kind of situation where we all in right now. This situation, psychologically, we call as time famine. Time fam is a French word which has been taken from French. Famine word is what exactly known as, if you have too much to do and you don't have time to do, that kind of situation is called as time famine. So don't be in a hurry that you have a lot of work to do, but you don't have time. Please manage your time properly so that you can do all the work. This is a stronger quotation given by somebody that don't say you don't have enough time. You have exactly the same number of hours per day that were given to Albert Einstein, Mahatma Gandhi, and Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. The great personalities who achieved lot many things in life, they also have the same time. It's 24/7 and the same number of hours, same number of minutes. So please don't complain that I don't have proper time to complete my studies, I don't have proper time to complete my project work, and I have a lot of work to do, but I'm not getting proper time. If you are not getting your proper time, you are complaining on that, that simply says that you are not managing your time properly. This is the present generation, this is the era where we are right now. Because in this digital era, in this smartphone era, we are all being bonded with these mobile phones. So even employees, students, homemakers, everyone is very much interested to spend time on mobile phones, but it will lead to very time killing things. We're all tied up with our mobile phones, with our smartphones. So using of mobile phone is not a crime, but using it in a proper way, use it a proper way so that you can get some information, so that you can get some knowledge from the phone, So not spending your time on wasting on social things, social media, and socializing activities very much important nowadays. But don't waste your time on unnecessary social activities. After, if you spend so much time on the phone or any other digital gadget, and then you can get lead to you feel like this. There is no time for me. Time has been ended. So tomorrow there is an exam. Tomorrow there is a project I have to submit. Tomorrow there is an assignment to submit. Tomorrow there is a meeting I have to attend. Tomorrow there is an attendee. There is an interview to attend. Students will feel like that. So if you waste your time by spending so much time on your mobile phone, you will, in the next picture, you can see the kind of reaction what you have. You will feel that time has been killed and I don't have time to get proper preparation. So my dear students, I am requesting you not you use your mobile phones very effectively. Use in a such a way that it will get good information, good activities from your phone, not it's a time killer, because these 2 years are very precious for you. If you spend your time wisely in the college, in the college activities, in the activities of teamwork, then you will be build your confidence, you can build your orator skills, you can build your public speaking skills. So please don't waste your time by using mobile phone so much, and then you will get leads to stress of time. It will lead to time stress. This is called as time stress. If you feel that you don't have any time to do the work, that will comes under time stress. So if you are under stress, you cannot read properly, you cannot attend exam properly, you cannot attend any interview properly, or you cannot complete any project, any assignment properly. So don't be under time stress. Please be use your mobile phone effectively. Please use your digital gadgets accordingly so that they will not kill your time. This is the kind of situation where we are living right now. Any family, most of the families which you have seen, this is the kind of situation. Everyone is there to take their lunch, but everyone is busy in using their mobile phone. This is just because that everyone is having their own work on their mobile phone, but simply they are socializing with other people, leaving the same persons in the same family within the same room. So please don't do all these things. Please educate yourself and please educate your friends, your family members also. Please don't be in this kind of situation. You are like this. This situation is called as alone together. They are all together in one room at one table to have their lunch, but they are alone with each other. They are in their own world. Please don't be like this. This is the situation where we are presently right now. This is a digital era where we are alone and we are together. And a research has been done in between 2015 to 2000, how parents are spending time with their children. The time spending with children has been increased because they are in the house and they are in the same room, but they are not with the children. They are with the children, but they are using their mobile phone and they are not taking care of their children. This is the kind of situation even parents and children are facing right now. So you please be don't use your mobile phone very too much, that it will kill your time. Time is, most of the people will say that time is precious, time is money, time is gold, time is everything like that. So the most of the people will say that time is money. There is a small story behind this, why time is called as money. In olden days, there was one lazy person who used to sit alone and don't do any work in the family. Everyone used to scold him that, you don't do anything and you are not perfect and you are not fit for anything to do. Even his wife used to scold that you are not able to do properly anything. And one day he was a very good friend of a king, and he used to go to the king and he said that everyone is scolding me and no one is appreciating me for what I am doing. The king said that you are not doing your things properly, so how can we expect other people will appreciate you? Not even your wife is appreciating you because you are very lazy and you are not doing things. But the lazy person asked the king, what I have to do to prove myself that even I am also fit for the society to live? And then the king ordered him, tomorrow morning by 6 a.m. you come to my treasury room. Up to 6 p.m. you will be there and you took all money in the treasury. No one will object you. And whatever money you took for morning 6 a.m. to evening 6 p.m., that money is all yours. And then that lazy person is very happy for that, and he left the kingdom and he went to home and he'll ask his wife, tomorrow morning I'm going to treasury in the kingdom so that I'll get money from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. that all money is mine. The king ordered me like this. The wife said, okay, tomorrow you'll go to the palace and get the money. As usual, the lazy person went to sleep, and as usual, the person in the next day morning woke up very late. By 8:30, he woke up, and then after getting woke up, and he used to have his breakfast, fresh up, and all those things. After completion of all these things, the time has been by 11 o'clock. By 11 o'clock, he started walking to the palace. After completion of 1 hour of walk, he said his feeling was, I'm very much tired. I'm done 1 hour of walking, so I need to take some rest. He took some rest at the side of the road and he went into sleep. After 2 hours of sleep, he woke up again. He eat some food and walked for next 2 hours. By 3 o'clock, he stopped somewhere and he feels that I walked many kilometers, so I need a rest. So he take some rest for the up to 5 o'clock. He took some rest and again he started walking towards the palace. At the end of the day, by 6 o'clock, when he reached the palace, the treasury gates were closed. And he went to the king and he said, King, you only said me to come to the treasury office to took the money. But the king said, I asked you to come by 6 a.m. Till 6 p.m. you will be there, you can took all the money. But you came late, you came after 6 p.m. So you did not get any money from the palace. So time is money. You need to use your time properly. If you have proper time management, if you woke up by 6 o'clock, you can get up ready by up to 7. And if you start walking by 7, you can reach the palace by 9:30, you can took the money. But you are wasted your time in sleeping and you wasted your time in eating. So you did not get any money. This, the moral of the story is, at the olden days, the time is money. If you are spending your time, that you should get some money in return. In the present generation, as per most of the psychologists, what they are telling is, time is not money. Time is more than money. Most of the people think that if you lose money, you can earn it back right now. But if you lose your time, you cannot get it back. If your 1 second is lost, you cannot get it back. At any cost, whatever may be the price, you cannot get it back. So time is not money. Time is more than money. Time is life. Time is small things which you can make yourself with others. Time is spending time with family, spending time with friends, spending time in college, spending time with colleagues, spending time with your juniors and seniors, so that you can have precious moments in life and you can treasure from all these things. Don't hurry in earning money so that your time will be killed off. You cannot get it back. If you lose your money, you can get it back. If you lose anything, you can get it back. But if you lose your money, you cannot get it back. So time is not money. Time is more than money. I think ROI, return on investment. Most of the finance students will come to know what is return on investment. As a finance student, if you invest some money in any shares or in any company, you expect some return, whether 10% dividend or 5% dividend, 10% interest rate, or whatever it may be, the return. So if you invest something in some project, you expect some return, so that you'll have some returns for the investment. That is called as ROI, return on investment. When it comes to time, it will call as ROTI. This is return on time investment. This is very important parameter in this present generation. If you need to have some returns, if you invest your time on some work, on even if you invested some time on somebody, you need to have get some returns in terms of knowledge or in terms of experience, in terms of cherishness, or in terms of money. If you are spending time of anything on anybody also, you need to have some returns on it. Exactly. It is not any selfish thing if you expect any returns if you are spending any time. Because if you expect any returns only, then you can use your time very wisely. Please don't give away on some small issues where you cannot have any experience or anything in return. So always invest your time where you can get good returns in terms of money or in terms of experience or in terms of knowledge. This is the present generation situation. This is called roti. These are the time management tips. How to manage your time properly? The time management tips comes under get up the same time each day. This is very difficult for most of the people because getting up early and getting up same time each day is very difficult. If you are managing and if you manage these things, then your time will be properly managed. So please get up at the same time each day and please go to bed at the same time each day. Get enough rest each night. In the earlier slide, I said that you need to have proper resting time so that your next day will not get be any effective. So then the third thing is include exercise in your routine. If you don't do any exercise or physical activities, your energy levels will be very down so that it will kill your time. If you want to complete your time, if you task in 10 to 15 minutes, you will do it in 30 minutes because your energy levels are very low. So please do exercise every day so that your energy levels, your morale and your things will be, your mood will be increased. And in the earlier slide, I said like that, when you need to prioritize your task, whatever may be the task, you need to have prioritized which one should be first and which one should be the second and which one should be the last. And create to-do list. After completion of all these things, please create a list which we are already completed. Break up your time into small chunks. Small chunks means small groups. In the morning hours, you need to have complete this task. In the evening hours, you need to complete this task. In the afternoon hours, you need to complete this task. So break your time. Break your 24 hours. This time is going to be for rest. This time is going to be for physical activity. This time is going to be for social activity. This is study time and this is a project work time. So break up your time according to small groups. Think about what you did each day and how you could do it better. If you are doing something today and think that how can you do it better tomorrow so that you will reduce your time wastage. So find out the different ways to done the thing in a proper way and a correct way by effectively and efficiently with small amount of time. If you are doing the small work in 10 minutes today, please try to complete it by 8 minutes or 9 minutes tomorrow so that you can get effectively and efficiently, you can do the work within lesser time and avoid distractions. There are a lot of distractions in this digital era because you need to have smartphones and you need to have digital gadgets and all this. And lot of social media is there to distract yourself. So please, at least for these 2 years, please avoid all the distractions from the digital gadgets. Whatever you get information from digital gadgets, it should be well and good for yourself. It should not kill your time. It should be in such a way that it will boost up your time management techniques, but it should not be in such a way that it will kill your time. So please avoid all the distractions. This is a famous quotation given by Steve Jobs when he's in a deathbed in hospital. Material things lost can be found, but one thing you can never, when you lose, is time. Steve Jobs, I think all of you know about Steve Jobs. He's a very hard worker and the founder of Apple. And when he was on the deathbed, when he was suffering from cancer, he used to quote these things. Material things lost can be found, but one thing you can never find when you lose is time. Because Steve Jobs used to spend a number of hours in his office so that he wanted to make his company in the top. But he used to make the company in the top position. But today, Steve Jobs is not there among us. So that is a kind of pathetic situation where we lost him. And he said that time is very precious. So don't lose your time. Spend your time wisely. Don't waste your time. Until you value yourself, you won't value your time. Until you value your time, you will not do anything with it. In the first slide only, I said you that time management is nothing but managing yourself. If you value yourself, you can do wonders. So until you value yourself, you won't value. Because you should not be available for everyone. Please learn to say no for a lot of things. Because they are not going to give any returns for you. So any other distractions you should not do. If at all it is very important and it is very a valuable thing will see you have to do. Otherwise, you should not do anything for the sake of others. So value yourself and be available very less time for others. Be available for yourself so that you can learn something and you can gain experience from doing things. You need to value your time and you need to value yourself so that you will do anything with this time. Otherwise, you don't value yourself or don't value your time, you will not going to do anything in this life. And I have the habit of taking good quotations from Ramayana, Mahabharata, and from all these things. This is a small quotation about time from Mahabharata. This is Kala means time. Kala pachi bhutani, kala samprate praja, kala satpurishesh jagrati, kalehi duratrikamaha. What exactly it means is time devours all things. Time destroys all things. Because whatever you destroyed in this world, it's just because of time. So whatever is there in the last day, if it is not there tomorrow or today, it will be destroyed by the time. So time destroys all things. Time kills all that are born. We are going to die one day. The time is going to kill us one day. But time is awake while we are all sleeping. You are sleeping, but time is awake. Whether it is morning or whether it is evening or whether it is night, time is always awake. Time is unstoppable. You cannot stop the time. So time is very precious. Time is very important. And time is everything in this life. Time destroys all things. Time kills all that are born. Time awake while all sleep. Time is unstoppable. This is a famous quotation from Mahabharata. You can use for your life. So that is the kind of importance you should give in your time, especially for a student life. Time is very, very, very important. So my kind request for all of your students is value your time. If you don't value your time, you are insulting yourself. You are not valuing yourself. So please value your time. A small story I would like to tell you how to value your time is one day one professor get a jar to the class. And along with the jar, he used to get small pebbles, sand, water, and small big rocks, small rocks. And he asked the students, is there any chance to keep all these four things in the jar? But most of the students replied that it is not possible to put all these things in the jar. But the professor used to say, I'll put it. And first he took the jar and he kept all the big rocks in the jar. And is there any space in the jar? He asked the students. All the students told that, yes, there is a space in the jar. And he said that small pebbles are there and small pebbles are being inserted in the jar. Again, he asked the student, is there any space in this jar? Most of the students slightly told that, yes, there is a small space. Then he poured the sand in the jar. And again, he asked the student, is there any space in the jar to pour water? Most of the students are told that, yes, there is a space. Again, he poured the water in the jar. That is the combination of jar where we can have rocks, pebbles, sand and water. The same way life is also like that. The first big rocks which the professor has been kept in the jar, those are the important things. You should do all the important things first. If you put the first important thing, then there will be small spaces where you can do less important things. If you keep water in the first itself, then there is no chance to keep the big rocks or small pebbles into the jar. So first do the important things. Second, the small pebbles indicate very moderate important things. And the sand indicates very less normal important things. And water indicates very less things which we can avoid also. So the life is a combination of all the things. Not only important things, not only wasteful things, not only less important things. It should be the mixture of all things. If you have only all these things, then it's called as life. And otherwise, it will not be called as life. So my kind request to all of your students is, please value your time. Unless you don't value your time, you are insulting yourself and you are insulting your time. So please value your time. And finally, your time starts now. And this is Venkat Vagalala signing off. And I thank you to the college management. I'm very much grateful to the college management for giving this great opportunity to have a webinar session with the MBA students about time, because time management is a very crucial thing in the present generation. So students also get to know how much important their time is. So please, ma'am, and please, sir, thank you very much for all the opportunity given to me. Thank you very much. And I wish you all the success, students, in your career also.
Sir, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, regarding one student, they wanted to ask one question.
Sure, sir. Yes.
Hello, sir.
Hello, sir.
My name is Srinath Suresh, sir. I'm second year
PA. Okay.
Specialization in finance and HR, sir. Sir, I'm high. I can be able to manage my time, sir. It is very fast, sir. So I'm having too many things to learn, sir. Time is unstoppable, sir.
Time is unstoppable. I said, you have a lot of work to do, but you don't find time to do. That's the situation. That's a psychological thing, which we call it as a time famine. So you need to first prioritize which one you are going to learn first. You are into finance and HR, na? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you are into finance and HR.
Sir, I can't audible, sir.
Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You are into finance and HR.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So my way of answering is, please prioritize your things. First, what you are going to learn and what you are going to do. If you want to learn something, whether it is important to for my career or not. If it is very much important, then make it as a priority list in the first place. And then the second place should be whether HR, in the HR also, if you have any problems and any subject problems, you need to be in the second place. So you need to have prioritized. I have given in this third slide, I think, you need to have five management skills. You need to have prioritizing of things, scheduling of things, to-do list things, and delegate, and having ample rest. So make the list of all your things, what you are going to do. And then in that, you cut short the things which you can avoid. And that from that, you can make your four priority list. Is it okay?
Sir, another thing, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
I'm also lacking in life skills, sir.
Life skills?
Means observation skill, analyzing skill.
Okay.
Listening skills, focus, concentration, attention. I'm lacking in this, sir.
Okay, because in this digital area, distractions are very common. The only thing is, if you want to have focus, listening skills, and analyzing skills. For analyzing skills, the best example is you need to listen to the other person very exactly, so that you can analyze what that person is telling. First, you need to improve your listening skills. After improving your listening skills, you need to analyze what you have listened, and then you focus on the subject what you are going to learn. So the thing is, you need to have proper concentration on listening to others. Most of the people have a prejudiced mind that if somebody is saying that I don't know, that kind of attitude should not be there for the students to learn. If you are interested to learn, you need to hear from all of the students and all of the professors also. So first, you improve your listening skills so that you can have an improvement in your analyzing skills and focus skills. And all life skills, it will not come one day. See, you need to have start from the day one. If you are starting from the day one, so that at the end of the second year, you can gain all these things. But if you are in the end of the second year, and if you are in a hurry to learn all the things at the same time, the time will not permit you to learn. Any other question?
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah. Any other question? Any other question?
Sir, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for the great opportunity.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, madam, for the great opportunity given for me.
Really, thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, thank you.
principal and
sir Venkat sir, thank you very much for your session and sharing your experiences.
Thank
lot
you.
Of examples and takes. I hope really students take the consideration seriously and start implementing it.
Sure, ma'am.
Because whatever is scheduled, we have 24 hours, as you rightly said.
Yes, yes.
It is all about how we plan, how yes. we implement it.
How to implement it.
That will make a difference in a busy day, or how you allocate your time for important things, urgent
yes.
things.
Yes, ma'am.
I really thank you from Sanskriti Group for spending your time.
Thank you,
and
ma'am.
Sharing your knowledge.
Thanks,
sir.
Thank you, ma'am. It's my great pleasure also for interaction with the students and yours. I'm very much grateful for the college management for giving this great opportunity. Thank you very much.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.